want to have this left hand a fair distance away from the elbow, you're moving his arm out of the way, for instance, to attack behind the elbow or under the elbow. And La Paso Chin Dash is pretty fair over here. Rear foot over 45 degree angle, so turn this rear heel out. This is so chinashi if you have no problem with the legs. And again, this should be good with Deanna's burger stance. All right. After the horizuki, you're shifting back, either blocking or performing kagishuto nuki, depending if your opponent grabs your arm or just knocks it down. Immediately upon contact, you're freeing yourself from here, and then jodai zikazuki. Similar theory, however, again, as I step from here, pivot on the ball of the foot, block, get angle out of hand back to the ear, palm open, and agi shuto uki. Then shift back, blocking one. One and step, jodai zikazuki. Coming up, kisobarachi. So, the application of the form to get an understanding of what you are doing. I'm attacking my opponent with a jodai zikazuki, stepping back with the left leg, agi shukauki with his right. Left. From this procedure here, he circles the arm that he's blocked with in and around as he steps, in a sense pulling the opponent off balance, holding the wrist, pulling him into that zikazuki. From this procedure, if I knock him down from here and I'm counterattacking, he's going to pivot on the forward foot, circle his arm up and around my hands, and knock it down and thrust midsection and chin at the same time. Okay. If the opponent intercepts, knock the hand down, you can shift back with a kagishuto nuki, move that hand out of the way, and counterattack. And counterattack. Good idea. Procedure from here. I'm attacking my opponent first with the meigiri and counterattacking with the shikizuki. It's blocked. Here I got an otoshiyuki from here. One and then two. Two. Alright. From the otoshiyuki, if I'm attacking from here, he can step forward and punch orizuki to the body. Or if I attack with the opposite hand, he would punch beyond the elbow from here. Two. If I knock it down with my elbow, he can copy shikanuki, controlling this arm so that he can have a clear shot of the chin with a jodai shikanuki. From that same procedure, variation of the previous technique. This time I'll change sides from here. I'm kicking meigiri and punching jodai shikanuki with my left. Kegai gadai and agi shikanuki. From this point, I'm going to continue the attack by kicking with the right leg, meigiri. He shifts back with otoshiyuki, blocking the kick, and then he'll counterattack with his jun meigiri. Two. And counterattack, shikizuki. Okay? That's your application to that point. From here, you're going to pivot on the foot, shift the body's weight. Therefore, stepping up into your neck watch couch is quite easy. Circling the arm in and around and slapping it against the hip as the other arm secures the elbow. One. Lunging forward with the Yamate Shizuki. Two. Coming out Kagiwabi Yuki. Three. And then Wate Shizuki coming out from here. And coming up. I think everyone can take a step to the right. Okay. Procedure from here. As my opponent turns. Let me use you on this side. As I'm committed to this position here, my opponent's attacking with Jodai Shikizuki, and I'm circling around. Clamping the arm against the hip from here as I would sprain the elbow, then attacking the body with a Yamate Shizuki. Okay? The Kagiwabi Yuki is quite apparent here. Okay? So, together. From our Jodai Shikizuki. From our Jodai Shikizuki. Okay? Coming up, and notice the pivot as I begin to move into this position. I'm halfway in my stance as I do that. Two. Five movements to a repetition. Two. You'll be standing there for a while so the judges can see.
Either this is a good fence, I'll score it high, or if the ball says, I will not score it high. And this hand is flat from here. Yes. From here, this is the fence. One, two, three, four.
Two.
So this is simply with your right hand in this case, you block basic make here. If he continues his forward attack and punches Jodai Shikinzuki, what you're doing is dropping the left hand on that of Shikinzuki and Nukute Zuki.
Or is that Teisho? I'm sorry, that's the Teisho, right? Then you have a five move repetition.
So, try, you have a lot of withdrawal movements, particularly having the right leg forward. I see quite a few heels come off the ground in order to shift. That would indicate your stance is too far long and it's too far to get your center over that heel. Shorten the length of stance, just extend the knee more. This way, you can get your center over the heel more easily without that quick. Five move, six move repetitions in front. Two. Six. That is a combined movement. And, yeah.